रहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुह। वेलकम इन मैथ क्लास ऑफ ग्रेड 7। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू विल बी फाइन। टुडे वी स्टार्ट अवर लेसन विद दुआ। रब्बी ज़िदनी इल्मा। ट्रांसलेशन, ओ माय अल्लाह इंक्रीज माय नॉलेज। नाउ ओपन द बुक, ग्लैंस एट द टेबल ऑफ कंटेंट्स। हियर योर फर्स्ट एंड सिलेबस इज यूनिट 1, 2, 3, 4 एंड 5। In this class, we will revise unit 1, which is about sets. What is set? A set is the collection of well-defined objects. Well-defined means there is no ambiguity about which objects belong to the set and which does not. For example, student of class 7 of the Sky High School is a set. And furniture in a room is also a set. Look at this example. All good school in Lahore. Is it set? No, it is not a set because we don't know how many school exist, how many good school exist in Lahore. Come to the page number 7. Here we will read how is a set represented. A set can be represented in 3 forms. First is descriptive form. When the set is described in word, for example, A is the set of first 5 natural numbers. And the second form is set builder form. When the property satisfied by the elements of the sets are written as a rule. For example, A is the set of x such that x is a natural number and x less than 6. The third one form is tabular form. When the elements of the sets are listed distinctly within a pair of curly brackets. For example, A is the set of first 5 natural numbers, which is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Come to the page number 8. Here you can see that this symbol belongs to. It's mean we said 4 belongs to A. It's mean 4 is an element of A. And the next thing is cardinal number. For example, A has 5 elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 5 is the cardinal number of A. Now move toward exercise 1A. Our first question is, write the sets below in set builder form, tabular form, and also write their cardinal number of each set. First question is, A is the set of all possible numbers formed by any two of the digits 1, 2, 5. Look at the question. Here we write this question in set builder form and also tabular form. A is the set of x such that x is the number formed by any two of the digits 1 to 5. In tabular form, we make pair of these digits. First, we make pair of 1 with 2 and 5, then 2 with 1 and 5, then 5 with 1 and 2. So, we make pair in tabular form. First, we make pair 1, 1 with 2, 12, and 1 with 5, 15. Now we make pair of 2, 2 with 1, 21, 2 with 5, 25. Now we make pair 5 with 1, 51, and 5 with 2, 52. The cardinal number is 6 because A has 6 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the cardinal number is 6. The second question is, B is a set of different digits of 101 whole power cube. We can write in set builder form x such that x is a digit of 101 whole power cube. And in tabular form, we will write digits 0, 1 and 3. The element of B set B is 3, 1, 2, 3. Now, then we write it cardinal number 3. Your next question is C is the perfect cube less than 25. For set builder form, we use x such that x is a perfect cube, x less than 25. Here we use less than sign in place of less. Now to write in tabular form, first we check the numbers. Taking cube of 1, 1 cross 1 cross 1, 1 multiply 3 times, its answer is 1. Next we check 2, 2 multiply 3 times, its answer is 8. Next we check 3, 3 multiply 3 times, its answer is 27. Here we can see that 1 and 8 less than 25 and we write in this set. But 27 is greater than 25, so this number not exist in this set. So the cardinal number of this set is 2. The question number D is for your practice. Now to move towards second question, which is write the sets below in descriptive form and tabular form and also write their cardinal. Here first question is, A is the set of x such that x is the square number and x less than 101. We write in descriptive form all square number less than 101, and in tabular form we write the element. Here the element is 1, 4, 9, 16 and so on. We know 4 is the square of 2, 9 is the square of 3 and 16 is the square of 4 and so on. The total element in this set is 10. So the cardinal number is 10. And the next question is B. B is the set of x such that x is an angle of pentagon A, B, C, D, E. We know the pentagon is like this shape and have 5 edges A, B, C, D and E. We can write in descriptive form all the angle of pentagon A, B, C, D, E. And in tabular form we write their angle. Angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D and angle E. It have 5 elements, then their cardinal number is 5. Question number C and D is for your practice. Now move toward question number E. And E is the set of X such that X is the letter used as Roman numerals. Now we can write in descriptive form all the letters used in Roman numerals. And in tabular form we write their elements, and elements are 1, 5 and 10. Here the cardinal number is 3 because it has 3 elements. Do practice of these questions. We will meet inshallah in next class. Take care. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome in lecture 3 of grade 7. This is your math class. Now open the book and come to the unit number 2. The topic of unit 2 is rational number. In this lecture we learn about the rational number, but before we learn about natural number, whole number, integer and rational numbers. Now we start natural number. Here natural number denoted by n, and its set start from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Natural number and also called counting number. The next number is whole number, and whole number is denoted by w, and it start from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. It includes 0. The next is integers, and integers is denoted by I, and it contain positive number and also negative number. For example, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and so on. And then rational number. Rational number denoted by q are numbers including integers and fractions. Integers mean plus minus 1, plus minus 2 and plus minus 3 and so on. And fraction mean 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 5. A rational number can be expressed in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. The set of rational number includes 0, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4 and so on into 1 and so on. Numbers which cannot be represented in the form of p by q are called irrational number. For example, under root 2 and pi are irrational number because under root 2 equal to 1.4, 142 and so on, it is not terminating, so it is called irrational number. Here you can see that q represents rational number, I represent the set of integers, w represent the set of whole number and n represent the set of natural number. Come to the exercise 2a. Here first question is, state whether the following statement are true or false. Correct the false statement. First A part is, 0 is positive number, false. 0 is neither positive nor negative.
The next question is 4 greater than minus 44, 04. Yes, it is 2. The next one is 2 into 3 by 5 will be on the right of the midpoint of 2.5 and 3.5. No, it is in the left side of 2.5 and 3.5, so it is false. The D part is the set of whole number includes 0. Yes, it is true. E part is set of integer is the subset of a set. Whole subset of the set of whole number, it is false because whole number are the subset of integers. The next one is rational and irrational number form disjoint set. Yes, it is true. G part, 0 is the multiplicative identity of the set of rational number. No, 1 is the multiplicative identity of the set of rational number, so it is false. The next one, rational number are associative with respect to addition and multiplication. Yes, it is true. When I part, when a rational number is divided by a non-zero rational number, the result is an irrational number. No, result is rational number. So it is false. The reciprocal of 7 by 4 is 4 by 7. Yes, it is true. Next, your second question is, write the following in descending order, but to write in descending order, we learn about the number line system. Come to the page number 20 and here you can see that we draw a line and plot a regular interval on it. For example, it starts from 0 and goes upward 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, and it goes downward minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. Here we plot interval 1 by 2 which is equal to 0.5. and 0.5 lie between 0 and 1. So we plot 0.5 in between 0 and 1 interval. And 3 by 2 is equal to 1.5. We plot these interval in between 1 and 2. Now come to our second question. Our question is, we write the number in descending order. First question is A. Let's see, number is 237, minus 237, minus 273 into minus 723 and minus 327. We arrange these number in descending order. First, we draw a number line and it starts from 0 and goes upward 100, 200, 300 into 400 and goes downward minus 100, minus 200 to so on minus 700. Now we can search the greater number and which is 237. 237 lie between 200 and 300. We plot these point at between 200 and 300. Here you can see that 237 lie between 200 and 300. And the next point is minus 273. Minus 237 lie after 200, after minus 200. And then the next is minus 273. And it lie after minus 237. The next one is minus 327 and it lie after minus 273 and in between minus 400 and minus 300. And the last one is minus 723 which lie after minus 700. Now we arrange the number in descending order, which is 237, minus 237, minus 273, minus 327 and minus 723. It is in descending order. Your next question is minus 7 by 9, minus 1 into 1 by 9, 2 by 9 and so on. Here first we draw the number line. It starts from 0 and goes into upward 1 to 5 and goes into downward into minus 3. Here you search the first greater number which is 3 by 9. Now 3 by 9 is equal to 0.3 and 0.3 lie between 0 and 1. And the next number is 2 by 9. 2 by 9 is equal to 0.2 and it is also lie between 0 and 1 but before 0.3. and the next number is 1 by 9, which is also lie between 0 and 1 but before 0.2. Now the next number is minus 7 by 9. Minus 7 by 9 lie between minus 1 and 0 and it is minus 0.7. And the next number is minus 1 into 1 by 9 and which lie after minus 1. And the next number is minus 2 minus 2 which lie at the same interval. And the next number is minus 3 which lie on the minus 3 interval. Here we can write in descending order 3 by 9, 2 by 9, 1 by 9, minus 7 by 9, minus 1 into 1 by 9, minus 2, minus 2 and at last minus 3. Come to the question number 4. Express each of the following as a rational number. Here the first is 0.2. Look at the notes. First we change the 0.2 in fractional part, but before change into fractional part we remove decimal. To remove decimal we place 1 in denominator and after decimal there is 1 digits and when we place 1 0. Here you can see that it become 2 by 10. Now cut it and it become 1 by 5 and in it is in the form of P by Q. Your next question is minus 1.25. First we remove decimal. To remove decimal we place 1 and after decimal there is 2 digits, we place 2 0. This become this and we cut this number, it become 5 by 4. We place 5 under division and divided by 4, then this become 4 ones are 4, 5 minus 4 into 1. So we can write it as 1 into 1 by 4. This is your question number 4. Complete your remaining question of question 2 and remaining question of question 4. This is your 2 days task and complete your task in 2 days. We will meet inshallah in next lecture. Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dear student, hope you will be fine. Welcome in class, welcome in lecture 4 of class 7. This is your math class. Now come to the unit 2. In previous class we solved question number 1, question number 2 and question number 4, but now in this lecture we will solve question number 3 and question number 5. The question number 3 is insert 3 rational number between the following pair. We have given 2 pair and we insert 3 rational number between them. Select a suitable unit distance on the number line in each case. We draw the unit interval also on the number line. Your first question is minus 0.02 to minus 0.01. Come to the notes. You see we have 2 interval, this and this. First we draw the number line and we set interval minus 0.02 here and minus 0.01 here. Now we insert 3 rational number between them. We know minus 0.019, minus 0.017 and minus 0.013 occur between 2 numbers, 2 pairs. Move to the next question, which is F part. Here the question is 3.001 to 3.001. First we draw the number line and plot the interval 3.0001 and here 3.001. Now we insert 3 rational number between them. The first number is 3.002 which come after 3.0001 and the next 3.005 which come after this number and the next 3.008 which come after this number. So we insert 3 rational number, this, this and this. Now move toward next question, which is J part. Here you can see that you have pair of number 7 by 10 to 8 by 10. First, you draw the number line. Here you plot interval 7 by 10 and here you plot interval 8 by 10. We know 7 by 10 is equal to 0.7 and 8 by 10 is equal to 0.8. We insert number between 0.7 and 0.8. We know 18 by 25 occur after 0.7 and we know 0.75 occur between 0.7 and 0.8. We know 39 by 50 occur between 0.7 and 0.8. So we insert three different numbers. You can look at this example. Come to the question number 5. Represent each of the following rational number on a number line. Here, your first question is 3 into 1 by 2. We represent these rational number on a number line. But our first step is to change this number into fractional part, and which is 7 by 2. How? We change this number into fraction part. How? 2 multiply 3, 6, 6 plus 1, 7, and it becomes 7 by 2. Now we divide 7 by 2. Here you can see that 7 is under division and 2 and divided by 2. 2 divide 7, then we get quotient 3.5. Place the 3. Now we find where 3.5 is located in number line. First, we draw number line and it starts from 0 to move upward 0 to 4 and to move downward 0 to minus 3. Here you can see that the 3.5 lie between 3 and 4. Now you plot this point on the number line. Your next question is D part, and which is 4.85. Here first you draw number line and it starts from 4.5 and goes upward to 5.0. Now you place the interval here 4.6, 4.7, 4.8, 4.9 and into 5.0. Now you check 4.85 where lie. The 4.85 lie between 4.8 and 4.9. Now you write the interval here. Your next question is E part, and which is minus 0.03. First, we draw the number line. The number line starts from 0 and it goes downward to minus 0.04. We place the interval minus 0.01, minus 0.02, minus 0.03 to minus 0.04. Now we check where 0.03 located. The minus 0.03 located here. Plot the point here. The remaining question of exercise 2A, question number 5, and part B, part C, to solve on rough sheet and also do practice. In next class, we will solve exercise 2B. This is your 2 days task. Complete your task on your rough sheets. Now your lecture time is over. We will meet next class, inshallah. Allah Hafiz.